God wants us to allow Jesus to rest and rule and abide in our lives today. Jesus wants us to get the message right, that Jesus came for peace, that Jesus came for us to have a new life, to have a new life and to live more abundantly. Jesus came to change this world, and it is up to us as children of God, as Christians, as saints of God, as sisters and brothers of Christ, to be able to continue to pass that message of peace to all those out there that we know that are living that life of unpeace, unrest. They're not living that godly life. It is our job to continue to pass the gospel and to continue to instill that peace of God in those that we come or may come encounter with. God wants us to continue to push the gospel, continue to pass the good news. God wants us to continue to tell of his goodness and of that day that he is soon to come. God wants us to continue to follow him, to continue to have that peace, to continue to do a work for him. Today, God wants the best for us all. But we have to do what God instructed us to do, which is to follow him. And he will make us for sure of him. That he will show us the things that we need to do before we leave this earth. God has sent his son to die on that rugged cross for you and for I. What are we doing to ensure others will get that relationship with God? Or are we being like those children of Israel on this Palm Sunday, missing the message that God has in store for us? God has a message for us all, and that is for us to continue to follow him, to continue to give that peace to others, to continue to be a blessing one to another. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. This day forth, continue to let the light that's within you shine for God evermore. Never rely on self, but always rely on God. Because God will never fail you or I. God knows what he's doing. God is yet still in control. Give it to God and let God rest and rule in your life. Let us pray. Oh, gracious Father, we come this afternoon just to say thank you one more time. Thank you for allowing us, oh God, to hear a word from you, oh God, that allows us not to miss the message, oh God, but to allow us to understand that you came for peace, oh God. You came for peace, but not only for you, not only for me, but you came for peace for this world. And oh God, we ask that you continue to dwell within each and every one of us this day, oh God. Oh God, come into this place, oh God, like never before, oh God. This place that we call your temple, which is our bodies. That living sacrifice that you have given unto us, oh God. Oh God, continue to rest, rule, and abide in each and every one of them under the sound of my voice, oh God. Let them know, oh God, that you are still in the saving business. Let them know, oh God, that you are still in the healing business. Let them know, oh God, that you are still in the problem-solving business, oh God. But we have to just give it all to you, oh God. And once we give it all to you, oh God, then we have to count it all joy. Because you have never failed us, and you will never fail us. But we have to learn to put our trust, our hope, our faith, our all in all into you, oh God. So, oh God, I ask that you continue to bless your people, oh God. That you continue to bless them, oh God, and them more, oh God. Continue to strengthen them, oh God. Continue to cover them, oh God. Continue to send your hand of protection over them and their family, oh God. Continue to travel with them on their daily journey with you, oh God. And let them know, oh God, that you are that way maker, oh God. That you will do what you said you will do. As long as they continue to seek after you and only you. Oh God, we bless you, oh God, we praise you. And we give the honor unto your name, oh God. We say thank you for all that you're going to continue to do this year, oh God. This day, this month. Oh God, continue to bless us, oh God, evermore. Oh God, we say thank you right now for all that you're going to do in this place.